Published 1651 EDT, the 15th of September 2017, updated 1722 EDT, the 15th of September 2017. That's what Jermaine Defoe does. Give him a chance and he will score, and his match-winning first goal for Bournemouth meant they picked up their first points of the season, and manager Eddie Howe could breathe a huge sigh of relief. The 34-year-old striker may not have the legs these days, but teammate Andrew Sermon made up for that with headers off the line at one end and an equalising goal at the other, after Solly March gave Brighton a surprise lead early in the second half. But what Defoe does have is a masterful finish, honed over decades, and his 160th Premier League strike against his 36th different Premier League opponent was as fine as they come. Substitute Jordan Ibe laid on both goals, and when he slipped in Defoe in the 73rd minute, there was no doubt the ball would end up in the far corner. Jermaine Defoe slides on his knees after scoring the second goal in Bournemouth's comeback win over Brighton. Jordan Ibe, who came off the bench for the Cherries, was key in the first and set up Defoe to put the hosts ahead. Bournemouth midfielder Andrew Sermon clutches the ball and roars in celebration after pulling his side level. Solly March had given Brighton the lead, giving them hope of a first away Premier League victory. After a scoreless first half, Howe has developed a look of constant concern in recent weeks, perplexed not only by Bournemouth's run of defeats but by their diabolical, troubling performances. The shine is beginning to dull from the golden boy of Bournemouth, widely touted as a future England manager, who recorded 0 points after 4 games. In seasons past, Bournemouth have lost matches but maintained a buccaneering, free-passing style. That was non-existent against West Bromwich Albion, Watford and Arsenal, and was only present for a half, at best, against Manchester City. It meant a match against newly promoted Brighton, who recorded their first top-flight win in 34 years against West Brom a week previously, took on vast importance and needed a response from Howe's players, one that did not arrive in the first half. Brighton's Pascal Gross chases a ball towards the Bournemouth byline with Nathan Ake in close attention. Brighton chairman Tony Bloom pulls on a woolly hat as he prepares to watch his side take on the Cherries at Vitality Stadium. Anthony Knockett beats Charlie Daniels as Brighton look for some respite in a first half dominated by Bournemouth. Shane Duffy escapes Jermaine Defoe with a clever piece of footwork that left the veteran striker on the turf. Defoe went closest for the home side in the opening period, turning and firing instinctively from the edge of the box. The England international knows just how close his effort was and reacts with anguish after seeing it go just wide. Davy Proper slides in to clear the ball as the Cherries continue to peg back the newly promoted side in the first half. Tomer Hemd leaves Ryan Fraser in a heap on the turf as the striker ploughs a lone furrow in the Brighton attack for all Bournemouth's early passing. Brighton had the first chance in the 9th minute when Anthony Knockett nutmegged Charlie Daniels on the right, dribbled inside and shot narrowly wide from 12 yards. Bournemouth had to rely on their opponents passing to them in the final third for their first chance. Brighton's Shane Duffy gifting the ball straight to Joshua King by accident, but even then the Bournemouth forward wasted the chance and his shot was blocked by Lewis Dunk. Daniels struck a long-range effort straight at Brighton goalkeeper Matthew Ryan, and a passing move found Mark Pugh inside the area, but he fired wildly wide. This was not what Howe had demanded. Dale Stevens watches as his header beats Asmir Begovic and hits the crossbar as Brighton piled on the pressure. Defender Shane Duffy was next to go close for the Seagulls as he once again hit the woodwork from a set-piece. Winger March would not be denied when Pascal Gross picked him out with a fantastic deep cross, heading home the opener. Duffy flies into action during the Brighton celebrations following Mark's goal in front of the away fans. Bournemouth turned to £15 million signing Ibe with his side a goal down. It proved to be an inspired changeth. Usually reliable Harry Arter kept giving the ball away, and it was almost costly when, on 29 minutes, Davy Proper dribbled from inside his own half, rode two challenges and went for a chip from outside Bournemouth's penalty area, only to hit the roof of the net. Straight up the other end, Jermaine Defoe turned brilliantly just outside Brighton's area, but his shot to the far right of goal bounced wide. It was the type of chance Defoe sank in his peak. The situation worsened for the home side at the start of the second half as Bournemouth's 6-yard box descended into a game of head tennis. Bournemouth had dominated possession and finally made the pressure tell when Sermon levelled in the 67th minute. The former Norwich man grabbed the ball as he celebrated his goal, knowing there was plenty of time to get a winner. Defoe clinically broke Brighton hearts when he made the most of Jordan Ibe's clever pass to put the Cherries ahead. Defoe wheels away after seeing his strike nestle in the back of net and complete the Bournemouth comeback. Pascal Gross swung in a left-hand side corner and Duffy headed across goal and on target from the back post, but Sermon headed off the line. Proper headed the rebound back at goal and Sermon nodded it out for a corner. Gross sent it back in. Duffy nodded on and Dale Stevens headed onto the underside of the bar, but the ball stayed out. 4 minutes later, Brighton made one count. Gross turned sharply on the right flank, crossed and March headed past Asmir Begovic. The game was getting desperate for Bournemouth, but a moment of quality had them level as Sermon proved as adept at putting the ball in the net as he was at keeping it out. The Bournemouth midfielder passed to Ibe, introduced 2 minutes before the equaliser, who backheeled back into his path inside the area. He stuck dunk on his backside and levelled. When Defoe struck the winner 6 minutes later, the relief was palpable.